How well do you sleep at night? Did you know that a lack of sleep can be making you fat and sick? But why can't you sleep? In this video, I will answer the question, why I can't sleep, telling you some of the causes of sleep deprivation. If you're new to my channel, welcome. Please make sure that you subscribe, click that bell so you always get my newest and latest uploads. I'm Dr. Janine Bowring, naturopathic doctor, best-selling author, TV personality, medical researcher, and the mother of five children. Please leave your questions and comments below. I love to get back to you, and I'd really appreciate it if you give me a big thumbs up on this video. So, the science of sleep and how to sleep better. So, what does a good night's sleep actually look like? Well, between 10 to 20 minutes after putting your head on the pillow, you should be falling asleep. And if that's not happening for you, then you may have a sleep disturbance. Also, the question always comes up, well, how many hours a night should we be getting of sleep? And most of the research shows that about 7 to 8 hours is best, depending, though, on where you live. So certainly with more light hours during the day and less darkness, then you might get away with a little bit less sleep. And certainly if you're in Canada, like right now with our dark, long winter, you probably need a little bit more sleep. But it's interesting because too much sleep can be a problem. And in this study, we can see, and I'm proud to say that this was done here in Canada at the University of Western Ontario, and this was from the world's largest sleep study that showed that people who slept between 7 to 8 hours per night did better cognitively than those who slept less than the 7 to 8 hours or more. So proving again that more than that 8 hours then is what re is required could be working against you in terms of making you feel not as cognitively inclined to be able to carry out your productive day. One other clue that you've had a good night's sleep is that you should be able to wake up feeling refreshed without an alarm clock. And that tells me that your circadian rhythms are in sync and that everything is working well. So again, why can't I sleep? And some of the other causes of sleep deprivation would be some EMF or EMR, so electromagnetic frequencies or radiation that are non-native. So native EMFs are naturally occurring. These are good from the earth. But the non-native EMFs, like the cell phone signals, the 5G, you know, if you're in a city that has now 5G, this is a big problem, as well as our laptops and all of those other devices that we have in our environment can mess up not only our memory, but they offset those crystals, so the calcite crystals that we have in our pineal gland. And this could be a big problem in terms of our circadian rhythms, but also with getting a good night's sleep. Also, the artificial blue light, so especially in the screen, so any screens that we look at, but also in LED light bulbs and our artificial light that we have, especially in the evening hours and going into nighttime, this has a negative impact on our ability to sleep because it's activating melanopsin. And when you activate melanopsin, this is turning off your melatonin, which is your sleep hormone. So, not a good thing. We have to limit our exposure to that blue light, especially at nighttime. Also, stress. So, we know that stress is a big problem when we're talking about getting that restful night's sleep. When our cortisol levels are all over the place, we simply cannot relax and calm down at bedtime, and we can't get that restful night's sleep. Also, how does diet affect our sleep? Well, eating late at night is a problem, especially carbohydrates, which a lot of us crave close to bedtime when our hormones are out of whack and our leptin is out of sync. And here we can see that eating those carbs, you know, before bed creates light to be given off in our microbiome. And then now this is going to suppress our serotonin conversion to melatonin because this ideally happens in a dark environment. So we've got to get dark at nighttime. We've got to say goodbye to those carbohydrates, especially after a certain time in the day, which is something that I'll share in another video, as well as lack of exercise. So we know the more we exercise, you know, not overdoing it, but if we're a couch potato and we relax too much, this could be a problem because we're not expending our energy that we need. I think of my kids when they've run around all day, especially outside, they're very tired and they crash at bedtime because they've expended that energy. So maybe you have to get a little bit more active to improve your sleep. Also, shift work. So here's a shocker. Shift work and, you know, doing those long hours at nighttime has been deemed a probable carcinogen by the International Agency for Research on Cancer. So yes, if you have the choice, you know, between choosing when to work, please do your best to try to work during the light hours of the day when our biology is supposed to be awake. Now, there are some hacks that you can do if you absolutely have to be a night worker, but that's, you know, a topic for another video. Also, the pineal gland. So if the pineal gland becomes calcified, and one of the things that does this is fluoride. So you want to limit your fluoride exposure. So in this study, what it shows is that the pineal gland can actually grow and heal and be more active in terms of melatonin by supporting the ability for it to not have fluoride. So when fluoride is taken out of the vicinity and the ability for these male rats to have fluoride, then their pineal glands get better and healthier. And this is important for humans as well, because we have more fluoride than what you would think. So whether it's in your unfiltered drinking water, you could also be using fluoridated toothpaste. And yeah, toothpaste, the benefits are not there, in my opinion, in terms of putting that fluoride into your body and the calcification that can happen in the pineal gland and completely offsetting your ability to sleep, amongst other things that we know that the, you know, pineal gland is important for. Also, lack of DHA is an important factor, and the further that you are away from the equator, the more of that DHA that we need, docosahexaenoic acid, which is typically from fish oil, and also, we need that DHA in terms of that morning sunlight as well. That combination of the sunlight, having enough DHA, turns that sunlight into an electric current, which our body can utilize in terms of energy to sustain us and, at the end of the day, to sustain a good night's sleep. So please share this video if you think it will help someone that you know with the information that I shared. And if you learned something new, please give me a big thumbs up. Also, hit that subscribe button and click the bell so you're always notified of my latest uploads. Remember to always take care of your good health and to do it naturally. Thanks for joining me today.